For the last 2 years, we have been transforming our unfinished basement to an epic home studio. So today I'm gonna bring you guys along and we're gonna tour the space. I'm gonna show you what we've been working on for 2 years.
Welcome to our studio. The studio is like a multi-legged sea creature. It has multiple facets, multiple legs, multiple arms, and multiple purposes, because this is actually a pretty big space.
When it came to designing this basement studio, it was really important for us to have these polished sets, but then also have a lot of storage. So you're gonna see a mix of like utility space mixed with kind of finished living space, and that was intentional.
When you first walk into the space, it's sort of a hallway area. To the left, we covered all the walls in black painted OSB.
We have a big wall of storage for our camera bags, and we wanted to hang these on our hooks because A, it gave us a good excuse to use our own hooks.
Which leads us to today's video sponsor, us.
Us.
We are slowly releasing a line of home decor products.
These are the second piece in our home accessory line. They are walnut wall hooks. They're made of solid walnut. They come in a pack of two with black hardware and hanging instructions. I believe the hooks can hold about 7 pounds, so these camera bags are all empty.
So we will leave a link in the description box if you want to check out where you can buy these. All right, moving on.
Black OSB here continues from the drone factory. Link up here if you haven't seen that video. And then you're gonna see it again when we move over into the studio, but let's continue on into the space. We have all these utility shelves here. This is not pretty, it's not supposed to be. It's supposed to be a quick look kind of gear shelf, so you need something, you need a light, an accessory, you come here, you look at it, and you can grab it pretty quickly. There's a bunch of different types of storage depending on what we're putting in here. We've got all of our Amaran lights, so they're actually all set up right now, so for this video. And then on the bottom, we have these Paul C. Buff Alien Bees. These are studio flashes left over from our photography freelance days. A lot of the gear you're gonna be seeing in today's video, we've accumulated over the last 15 years. So some of the gear on the shelf here, we've actually had for 15 years. And other things we've just kind of been adding as time goes on. Lights, backdrops, boxes, two reflectors, very important. If you haven't seen my 8 studio must-haves video, link up here, check it out. All right, let's go into the main space. So as I mentioned, this space is a mix of utility, storage, and then also kind of some styled moments. And along this kind of cinder block wall here, we have some old dressers that we had left over from our last apartment. This gives us nice storage space for all those little things that kind of get lost. When you're into photography and video, there's all sorts of teeny tiny accessories and tools. So this gives us a nice space to store all of those things. And it also gives us a nice surface to style on top of. We've got some books here, faux plant, because there's no light down here. Something to think about when you're adding books to your space is to add books that you would actually look at that kind of represent your interests. So you're gonna see a lot of graphic design, interior design books around here, architecture books. These are things that I'm into. And when you're styling your space, you wanna pick things that represent your personality. You don't want somebody to come into your space and be like, oh, you're really into math? And you're like, no, I like design. So don't pick a book just based on its cover if the contents of the book doesn't interest you.
We have 3 framed photos on the wall that's mounted directly to the cinder block. So those photos are from our Cold Island series. We'll link to that series in the description box below.
So inside the studio, we're kind of mixing Godox lights, Aputure lights, Amaran lights, and in all of our lamps, we have the B7Cs. Except for in those pendant lights, which we'll get to later. And this gives us nice practical lighting without getting any flickering on camera because they are built to be on video. They're color changing, you change the temperature and also change the actual color.
Moving past that part, we walk into the main area of the studio, and on your left, we have the podcast setup. Now, the podcast setup you've probably seen from our podcast Tuxedo Time. If you haven't seen it, linked in the description box. This is actually basically our old living room furniture from our apartment days. Just ported down here.
It actually works out perfectly because the couch is apartment size, so it's smaller than a normal couch, which is perfect for set design because we don't have a lot of space to dedicate to a full-size couch. So this is where we record our podcast Tuxedo Time. If you haven't checked it out, link up here.
So the podcast setup is based around a Rodecaster Pro. We're gonna do a whole video on this setup, so we won't get too in-depth here now. The lights themselves, we've got a Godox light as our main key light and basically a little tiny, small softbox that will essentially illuminate the entire scene.
We have the B7Cs inside the lamps. We have the Aputure M9 inside this little light fixture here. And we have this set up to look like a living space. So we wanted this to be styled. We wanted the set to feel like you were kind of hanging out with us in the living room. And so that's kind of what we went for here. We added some sound panels on the ceiling as well as a rug on the floor just to kind of dampen the sound. We left the concrete floor bare because we didn't want to fully finish out the space or cover up the ceiling, so a rug kind of helps with the sound here. Looks like a lot of stuff in here, but there's actually 5 different sets in here. We're gonna do a different video where we break down each set in detail. If you've watched some of our older videos, you might have noticed in the corner there used to be pipes here. We took the OSB from the other space and kind of copied it again over here. It's in the drone factory, it's on the bag wall, it's here in this divider wall. And the sole purpose of this is just to block off those pipes so it looks like a finished space, but obviously it's just hanging here from the ceiling once you take a peek behind the scenes. So that just covers up the pipes here, and behind here we just have a couple of extra sound panels that we can move around. And of course right here we've got the charge wall, which you guys have seen in a video, link up here. If there's no room, link in the description box. We use the Aputure Situs Link app, and we have everything kind of hooked up to that so we can control it from the iPad there.
Moving into the center of the room, there's a big post in the middle of the room, so we had to kind of work around that, but I find it doesn't really limit us too much.
We kept the middle of the studio super open so we can move around lights. There's nothing worse than when you're trying to move stuff around and rig stuff up to be tripping over things. So there's a lot of empty space, and that's why we kept those spaces there. What is this called? Lint roller. We have a clothing rack here with a lint roller and some hangers.
Surprise, surprise, we bulk film a lot and we have to change outfits, wardrobe sometimes, yeah.
Or if we have a product that we're showcasing, we can hang it on the rack as well. And then next to that here is a utility cart, which is a key piece to a studio. For us, this has been really helpful. It kind of has multiple uses. So obviously we have some storage here on the sides with our gaff tape, extra extension cord here. We've got this old Apple display that's sitting on top here. It's kind of great because we can hook our laptop up, we can watch videos here, but also I can easily move this to the desk setup if we want to shoot a tutorial with kind of a more desk looking scene.
And that actually doubles as a production cart if you're doing a shoot down here and you need just other extraneous stuff that you need to put on the cart, that can wheel around the room.
And we have a keyboard and mouse just stored down here on a Grove May desk pad. Shout out to Grove May for sending us that. And then kind of like a little catch-all that has a bunch of just extra stuff. There's like a gray card thing in here, some filters. So that is our utility cart. That cart came from CB2. It's on wheels, can lock, we can move it around. We love.
Okay, moving into the far side of the basement, we actually have a couple different areas here. The first one is sort of our main studio setup.
Yeah.
It's the slat wall set, and we made a whole video showing how we built that. That was a bit of a pain.
So we built out this matte black slat wall. We knew we wanted to have a bit of a textured background when it came to shooting our videos. Originally, we were gonna go with the OSB and then decided to go with the slat wall. So you have some fake plants here, which is key when you don't have a lot of natural light. You don't want your plants dying. We've got another Godox light mounted to the ceiling with some barn doors, and that just kind of shines directly on the slat wall to give it some depth. We wanted to make sure that you guys could see the detail in the background so it wasn't just one big black dark shadow. So that's kind of the purpose of that. So again, this is our main set. So we have our overhead rig here for shooting top-down video or for shooting with a mic, which is hooked up here. And of course the Aputure 120D with a big softbox on it. That's our main light source for this angle. And we have these little pendant lights over here. These are Arlo pendant lights from EQ3. And they don't have the B7Cs inside. They actually have Philips Hue lights inside because of the way the insides are kind of set up. It just made more sense to just have Philips Hue in those paper lanterns. Now with the Philips Hue light bulbs, if they're dimmed, they will flicker on camera. So I have found so long as they are on full bust, they don't flicker. A couple of sound panels above here. Like I said, we usually shoot most of our videos over here. And we actually have a couple of plugs in the ceiling as well, which is really great to get all of those cables up off of the ground. Of course, we have our standing work desk here on wheels.
A desk on wheels. We can move the desk around. It also changes height, which is very handy. So not just having it a standing versus sitting workstation in this corner, but we can actually move it around the whole studio, say rolling it next door to the backdrops, which are permanently hung on a backdrop holder.
So we added some backdrops here on the ceiling. These are the Impact Backdrop something title. They're linked in the blog post as well. The paper backdrops are from BH. We got black, like a creamy gray, and a dark gray, and these we can actually move up and down super easily. So if we wanna shoot any product photography or a headshot or something, everything is easily set up so we don't have to break out the backdrop stand and then set something up and tear it down. And the whole wall here is painted white. So once those backdrops are up, if I need a big white wall to shoot against, we have it.
So moving past the backdrops into the other corner, which is not actually a corner because this whole space is just one contiguous area that goes into where our furnace is, where the pump and all that stuff, all the utilities in a home, they're hidden behind the, wow, the wall on wheels. Keep up guys, everything's on wheels. So the wall on wheels, we also again, made another video about this. We can link it to the description box below. But the wall on wheels has two sides. One is the black OSB, which again picks up from the drone factory, picks up from the entrance of the studio, so it's all one cohesive space.
This just gives us a little bit of a different textured background. We got a little bit of a simple gallery wall built out here with pennants from Oxford Pennant and some prints that I picked up, as well as the B7C hung just to give a little bit of a practical light.
And the other side is just standard, basically just plastered drywall, which is painted. Come on, please. Any color you want.
We all thought you were gonna say matte black. So that's actually on wheels. We can pull it out into the space here, build out a custom set for a project, and that's kind of fun to be able to transform the space depending on what we're working on. This light is a signal light from CB2. It's just a normal floor light. B7C is inside. Moving over here, we've got some curtains hung to separate the studio from the utility section of our basement. Over here is where we store our tripods, light stands, and softboxes. We have three tripods here. Our podcast is three angles, so we use the Peak Design tripod as our main tripod for all of our videos. And then we have a couple of different ones, ProMaster and a Manfrotto Legs here. And they both have Joby 5K ball heads on the top because they take the Peak Design plates, which are on all of our cameras. Now all of our light stands are kind of hung on the wall here with this little broom thing, and this is just attached to the center block with double-sided Velcro, and it's been holding up pretty well. And same with these soft boxes. These are also attached to the wall via double-sided Velcro. So these soft boxes all have Velcro already on the inside. So I just stuck the opposite to the wall and they just kind of stick on the wall like that. So yeah, so that is it. That is our studio, guys.
Well, 2 years, was it worth it?
Yeah, I think so. I wish it took less than 2 years, but here we are. It's almost time to repaint and redesign it.
Oh my God, no. This is done. This is over. We will see you guys in the next one.
I like math.
I know you do.
Holder that has changed.
It's a DAO.
A desk on wheels. Anything's on wheels has OW after it.
Okay.
Yeah, like if I put you on wheels, I call you a bow. A Becky on wheels.
I want a bow.
Oh, like B-A-U?
B-A-O.
B-A-O. Oh my God. I'm a terrible Asian.
Jesus. Yeah. Can you hear that? That's my stomach growling. I'm so hungry.
B-A-O? Was it B-O? What is it?
B-A-O is bow.
B-A-O.
Bow.
I can't spell it.
Bow down.
Bow down.
Why did this space take us 2 years to film?
Why does every project take us 2 years to finish?
Foreshadowing.
Foreshadowing. Foreshadowing.